Fleury out of the net to play. Lost it to Pacioretty. Oh, and Fleury with a great save off Galchenyuk. Just got the glove arm out. Pacioretty again. Scores! The captain takes the torch and lights the lamp first in Montreal.
Back for a start, the home opener here in Montreal, and all first opportunity. Fleury does not play the puck well. He's lucky he didn't get scored on there. Galchenyuk with the glorious opportunity. The puck comes back to the point. Real nice pass, tape to tape on the stick of Max Pacioretty. And that's a goal scorer's goal.
Schuster there. Garrison lost it to Shaw. Hands it off for Pacioretty. Back to the line. Patterson to Pacioretty. Scores! Pacioretty gives the Canadiens the lead.
And what a finish from Pacioretty. But this play, it is all Andrew Shaw and a relentless forecheck. He wins the battle, ends up getting that puck back to the point. Good mobility by Greg Patterson. Walks to the middle of the ice and creates a shooting angle for Pacioretty. And look how quick that puck is off the stick of the captain. It's not the hardest shot, but it's because of the accuracy. And there's the forecheck. Shaw goes in, takes the body on Garrison. Slings that puck over to Pacioretty. Pacioretty gets that soft spot, and what a release off the center.
Handling his back. His partner lifts one high to center. Knocked down by Shaw. Tucks the head a little bit. Pacioretty made a move to shoot it, and then center, that's good! And all was in front of the net and set up beautifully. 5-0. Montreal.
Bob, I thought the same thing, that Danault had rifled this in the back of the net. We'll have a look and see if it might have gone off a helm. Max Pacioretty, who took a forehand to a backhand and kind of missed an opportunity just earlier, is going to drive down the outside and then go to his backhand. This is where Pacioretty really is getting his game back. When you see that outside speed, this looks like it goes off the skate of helm. And I think that's why Danault was pointing at Pacioretty right away.
Play back around for Pacioretty, up to Nathan Beaulieu. Back for Pacioretty, into the middle, scores! Max Pacioretty with that quick release puts it over the shoulder of Luongo and in. A power play goal, and the Canadiens take the lead.
Talk about quick release. Max Pacioretty is going to cycle this puck up high to the point. Finds a little open ice, quick spin, and there's that puck. Now you see it, now you don't. That thing was in and out of there. I don't think anybody knew, including Luongo, just looked back and said, yeah, that's a pretty darn good shot. And it's all about release, and he gets an off.
A long shot type of thing will happen.
Here's Plekanec with a shot that just goes wide. Pacioretty scores! Well, that's the start to the period the Canadiens were looking for, and maybe the start of their line starting to get some production from the big top guns.
And talk about timing, it's almost like they heard what we're talking about up here. It's the big line. And right away in this period, Pacioretty, another one of those funny bounces you're talking about, Johnny. Just persistence, and Plekanec just shoots it towards the net, bounces off the end boards, and Ward awkwardly looks back for that puck. It bounces and he just can't cover up that post, and Pacioretty just slides it off the back of his skate and it goes into the back of the net. Fortunate bounce, but just simplify, get as many pucks as you can at him.
Here's Pacioretty, scores! Max Pacioretty on the feed from Andre Markov, and the Canadiens strike first.
And that's one way to do it. I mentioned time for the leadership core to step up. So who better than the captain, Max Pacioretty and Galchenyuk. This all comes from a faceoff win. Something they've really been harping on. Galchenyuk wins it back. A great pass. Pacioretty goes out to that soft area. A real smart play by Pacioretty.
Okay. Shaw again parked in front. Now moves away as Rabula will go to the point for Pacioretty. Pacioretty with a shot scores! David Desharnais back right in front of Peter Budaj. But Max Pacioretty gets the shot through and the power play goal ties it at two.
Yeah, smart decision there from Pacioretty. Didn't tee it up and take the slap shot. Just a nice quick snapper. He just gets it on net. Montreal establishes that puck control. They get the setup they want. Nice little pass over to Pacioretty. I think that might have deflected off Desharnais on the way in. As Pacioretty just releases that snapshot. I think that hits a couple bodies, John, yeah, on the way in. Looks like it changed directions once. And right in front of the net.
Schneider out of the net. And Sudoffin turned over in front. Pacioretty scores! The captain jumps on the turnover and his backhander sneaks through the legs of Corey Schneider and it's 4-1.
Pacioretty is eighth goal of the season and Quincy puts this puck up the boards and then Wood tries to one-touch it but goes right back to the Canadiens, ends up on the stick of Max Pacioretty.
Two, hands it away, Pacioretty steps in, ready, set, scores! Pacioretty arrows it to the corner and Montreal's up 2-0.
Well, that's his fourth goal in four games and it's Tootin's fault and I'll tell you why. When you don't have a play, it's all about puck management and the critical turnovers for Colorado has really been chewing this team up and that's a critical turnover. You don't have a play, instead of giving it back to your partner who's wide open, you try an ill-advised play through the middle of the ice and you hit the Montreal Canadiens going the other way and it's Max Pacioretty who steps right into it, walks right on his forehand and rips it top.
Puck comes back, tip scores! Pacioretty with his second!
The Colorado Avalanche over the last six games have led the league and have been around 60% on faceoffs, and the Canadiens have been struggling, and there's a clean win by Plekanec. You win the faceoff, the Avalanche get out, but they don't get in the shooting lane. And this puck comes to the net, and it's a tip for Pacioretty, who's kind of working his way back towards Markov, towards the in-tight hash marks. He just lays this
to the line again. Redmond ricochets it up around, back of the net. Plekanec, Radulov gets it across, scores! Pacioretty with the hat trick! And and his fifth career hat trick.
I mentioned he's just starting to percolate. He does score them in bunches, and his teammates, you know, Radulov was looking for him. But talk about activating your defense. Zach Redmond comes up the ice, he jumps into the play, and he's going to carry the puck into the zone. He will carry it into the zone, then eventually he will come out of the zone, and Beaulieu will go into the zone. And this is a rotation where you're activating your D constantly, and there's Beaulieu coming in, Redmond moves out, and all of a sudden now it goes back to the point, down the wall, and the Montreal Canadiens win another 50-50 puck battle. Again, he cannot handle a puck on the wall, and it ends up pumping right out in front to Radulov. Beauchemin has him, he leaves him, and it's in the back of your net.
And stepping up, looks towards the front, centers it in. And a couple of jab scores! Mitchell! It was Pacioretty who gets it. And that is his fourth of the night.
what happened. The shift was going on so long in the Colorado end that some of the players had changed for Montreal, and they actually had fresh troops on the ice, and that's why Mitchell's out there with his line. And again, the Montreal Canadiens hunt down the puck, and it's just guys all alone. There's Mitchell, who came on the ice, circled in, went right to the front of the net untested. He takes the first whack at it. Pickard doesn't have it.
And he doesn't know it. And it's the captain, Max Pacioretty, who glides right in. Not going to get an easier goal than that.
Petrie back to the Ducks line as Holzer got it ahead. Cogliano tipped it, but now it's Pacioretty back in. Gallagher's open. Pacioretty scores! Pacioretty used Gallagher as a decoy and then took the shot and put it in behind Bernier, a man who he's had a lot of success against. And it's 4-1 Montreal.
No, he really has. He's one goalie that he loves to shoot the puck against. And Pacioretty gets this long stretch pass and just holds it for an extra second, waits for Bernier to open up, and just snaps it by Jonathan Bernier. And he absolutely owns Bernier. 9 goals in 9 games coming into tonight's game. And Pacioretty continuing to have success against Jonathan Bernier. And most of the success coming back to Bernier's days with the Toronto Maple Leafs. And one more look at tonight's goal, that patented Pacioretty snap.
By Weber, Spurgeon at the line, lost it. Pacioretty coming in, rolling puck, scores! The captain strikes for his 14th of the year and 6th goal in the past 8 games against the Wild.
Wow, this is a goal scorer's goal. Look at Pacioretty just take off like he shot out of a cannon. And right there, he changes the angle. No curl and drag. And pulls Dubnyk over just a touch and goes far stick. Look at Pacioretty, head up, picks that.
Weber after it. Canadiens now with relentless pressure on this power play. Radulov to Pacioretty, scores! And the power play finally works as the captain, Max Pacioretty, extends his point streak to 6 games against the Panthers and makes it a 1-1 game.
And Pacioretty was tapping his stick, wanting this puck in the high slot. It's some great pressure by Montreal. They work this puck around. There's the stick tap in the high slot. Pacioretty gets it, just zips it right through the 5-hole on Reimer. And Radulov is such a brilliant passer. There's the release, and there's Gallagher doing what he does best. Reimer can't see. He has to look around the body of Gallagher, and that little adjustment right there opens him up just enough
for Nathan Bolger. Now fired in down low. Radulov behind the net. Looks out front. Center. Pacioretty scores! Max Pacioretty, the overtime winner, set up by Alexander Radulov. And the Canadiens win it 2-1 in Nashville.
And so much talk of Shea Weber's return to Nashville, but it's Alex Radulov, the former Nashville Predator. And we all sometimes forget Radulov's departure here in Nashville, and left after that playoff series, was out, missed the curfew, went back, played in the KHL, and returns here to Nashville and sets up Max Pacioretty on a beautiful effort behind the net, and then Radulov with his skill on full display behind the net, quick hands and a lightning fast pass on the stick of Max Pacioretty, and Radulov steals the show here in overtime. And right there on the backhand to the forehand, quick little pass, and Pacioretty with the quick release and the reaction from Radulov.
Back for Bolger. Across, Pacioretty fires, and that one is wide. Gallagher is hunched over on the Canadiens bench. And you've got to think he's saying, not again. Pacioretty scores! Top corner, power play goal. And it's a 3-2 lead as Gallagher is trying to hustle off down to the hallway.
Gallagher's a tough customer, too, and this doesn't look good. And he missed time last year
with a couple broken fingers, and Pacioretty with the big goal. But here's the shot, a one-timer, and Weber gets all of that. And right away, Gallagher's in trouble. And soon after that, on the point, Beaulieu, quick little pass. And that Pacioretty, quick little snapshot. It doesn't take him long to release that puck. And right in front of the net, great screen. I believe that's Michael McCarron. And
John Klingberg on it. Klingberg trying to center for Fox, and that got blocked. Deneau at it and escapes. And now the long pass, and it's Pacioretty in alone. Pacioretty makes Montreal Canadiens history. The overtime winner. Seconds into the extra frame, and Max Pacioretty with his 8th career overtime winning goal.
And so much for the importance of winning the draw, because Dallas won that draw. But a great pass, timing pass from Jeff Petrie, catches Pacioretty in full flight. Pacioretty explodes, all kinds of time here on this breakaway, and great patience, head up for a split second, and beats Lettinen through the 5-hole. Great reaction from the captain. Yeah, one would have to think it would be Pacioretty end this game if he would indeed get the opportunity. And there's the reaction, the dejection from John Klingberg, and Max Pacioretty making history here for the Montreal Canadiens. A huge goal here in overtime in Dallas.
Game. The Canadiens get into the attacking zone. Weber with his first slap shot, and it's a changeup. Anderson had to make a save. Radulov in front, they score. Max Pacioretty, 20 seconds in, 1-0 Montreal.
Couldn't have drawn up a better play there if you're the Montreal Canadiens, jumping on a team that played last night. This all starts, though, with Radulov. Radulov does a bump back play against Nazem Kadri. Kadri, you mentioned, he has the assignment always against the top team, but right here, look at the quick bounce back there, knocked him right on his rear end. And then from behind, Pacioretty finds that little seam. Zaitsev has him for a second. The rebound was there, and Radulov, as he's found Pacioretty so often lately, just perfect pass and right underneath the arm of Frederik Andersen.
That is not why he's playing with the Canadiens.
This was a missed pass from the Canadian end. The pass was meant for Galchenyuk in the middle of the ice, and he missed it. And everyone missed it, and the speed of Pacioretty blows by McDonough, and he beats Henrik on the 5-hole. And you know what? You gotta have a save here.
Chips it off around the boards. Alexander Radulov throws it in front. Galchenyuk over to Pacioretty. Scores!
Max Pacioretty makes no mistake about that one, and another power play goal makes it a 3-1 Montreal lead.
Look at Radulov. I don't think there's a guy that's more excited when other guys score goals than Alex Radulov. Great zone entry into this offensive zone, and consecutive backhand passes. One from Radulov over to Galchenyuk. Backhand pass, no looker to Max Pacioretty. There's that patented quick release off the stick of Max Pacioretty, but what a saucer pass to boot from Galchenyuk. And some great passing, and an even better finish from Max Pacioretty.
In over the line, feeds it down low. Foligno dropped it back, but it's intercepted, and Pacioretty's on it. Up ahead for Alexander Radulov. Radulov cutting in to Pacioretty, he scores! Pacioretty finishes off the play for his 22nd of the season.
Great finish from Pacioretty. Elevates that up and over Robin Lehner, but Radulov, just such an excellent passer, and especially on the backhand. We've seen this so many times from Radulov. He's able to make plays at top speed and on the backhand. Beautiful.
Deneau Rolls it off the boards down the wing, trying to go after it. Reinhardt there as well, played it back, but it's Foligno, the interception. Now grabbed by Dino, right in front. Pacioretty scores! Alexander Radulov sets up the captain again for his second of the night, and it's 2-0.
Now what a release off the stick of Max Pacioretty. Turnover down low. Radulov with the initial forecheck. And there's Deneau over to Radulov. The quick pass. And that's the key. Radulov does not waste any time getting this puck. He one times it. Gets it quickly to the stick of Pacioretty.
Body in front. I believe it caught Justin Falk. Sabres don't get it out though. Radulov back on it. Dancing in. He'll take it back in the net. Holds on to the puck. Radulov with a chance. Shot got blocked. Pacioretty scores. Pacioretty win the hat trick, and it's 5-0 Montreal.
And this big number one line for the Canadiens been having their way with the Sabres, and Radulov again, the strength on the puck and the patience as he holds onto the puck, comes out of the corner, throws it towards Robin Leonard, and right in front of the net, Deneau knocks Leonard, I think just a little bit off balance, and right after, Pacioretty is going to shoot the puck, there's Deneau, he gets pushed in to Leonard. Leonard slides out of the way, and Pacioretty's there to deposit that puck right by Robin Leonard. There's...
That'd be something if he did it here in Montreal. There's Radulov, though. Trying to answer back. Got it across to Pacioretty. Scores! And the Canadiens do respond. This time the captain's got the goal, and they're within one.
Max Pacioretty steps up with a huge goal in the third period. Canadiens win the battle down low, and then Radulov, as he's done so many times this season, excellent on that backhand side, comes around the net, throws it right to the high slots, tape to tape, and Pacioretty with the quick release and puts it by Braden Holtby. And Pacioretty wasn't happy after that last missed call, and you see
there's Alexei Yamalin handing it off for Petrie. Played up through center as Max Pacioretty will tip it in. Oliver Ekman Larson after it. Misses it in front. Pacioretty scores. Max Pacioretty gets the goal 57 seconds into the game. And the Canadiens will not be shut out tonight.
Well, almost a polar opposite to the start they had against Colorado. The puck gets deep and in on the forecheck. Radulov pokes the stick, and then Deneau wins this battle for the puck. Ekman Larson skates right by the puck, and Max Pacioretty right.
He's got it. He'll slide it over to Markov. Coming in, trying to center. Pacioretty scores! What a shot by the captain. His second of the night. And the game is tied at 3.
And there's leadership 101. Leadership. It's not always what you say in the dressing room, it's what you do on the ice, and no better leadership than coming out in the third period and scoring a big goal on the power play. And it's that patented Max Pacioretty snapshot right in the high slot, and this has been an issue for the Coyotes all game. Pacioretty, it doesn't take him long, open for a split second, and the release just right up to the top corner.
Along the board, back to Patterson, looking, gets it across, Beaulieu controls that puck, scores! Shot, it looked like Pacioretty may have tipped it. We'll see, but Montreal has tied it.
I don't know if he's going to get a point on this, but thank number 47, Radulov. What a shift for Radulov. His doggedness on the puck, and there he pays the price to bump Bertuzzo first, keeps the puck alive. He just battled that whole shift, and the Montreal Canadiens keep it in the St. Louis zone. They're guilty of not battling hard enough. And then this shot from Beaulieu, it's not a hard shot, but it's placed in the right place. And Pacioretty gets position on Bertuzzo.
And Hyman goes for a skate. can't dump the puck in. Pacioretty back the other way. Shaw has just stepped off the bench into the middle. Galchenyuk picks up, score! Pacioretty with a bullet and a tie game, 1-1. Pacioretty matches Matthews at 29.
And here's a prime example of the most inspired man is the man that turned the puck over, and Pacioretty chases him down in the neutral zone, then just gets lost. Look at all the attention on the puck carrier, and Pacioretty on his offside just slides away from traffic, gets himself set, and just a quick release.
There's Radulov knocking it down. At the point, Beaulieu with a shot to the net, Schneider the same rebound, scores! Pacioretty, number 30! It's a one-goal game again as Max Pacioretty hits the 30-goal mark for the fourth straight season, becoming the fifth Canadiens player all-time to do that.
Well, talk is cheap, and the best leadership is leading by example and leading by your actions, and Beaulieu just throws that towards the net, and Pacioretty, Johnny on the spot, quick little snapshot, and Schneider caught out of position, short side wide open.
Knock it down low, under a minute to go now in the third. Pacioretty with a shot, scores! Pacioretty's tied the game as it just sneaks in over the line. That puck just made it through. And it's a 3-3 game.
And they're going to have a look at this, but I got a great look from up here, John, and I think you're in agreement. That was clearly over the line, and we'll take a quick look at it right now as Pacioretty comes to that spot where he loves to shoot the puck. Look at Andrew Shaw getting in front of Corey Schneider, and that clearly goes over the line just enough. It just trickles through the legs. And there's Captain Andy Green trying to save it from going completely over. And on the overhead cam,
Canadiens have to come back to regroup, and Markov has the puck now. Right through the middle, that pass straight ahead, Pacioretty comes on. It's deflected, score! Galchenyuk and Pacioretty, and it hit a stick high and went in the net. And the Canadiens have taken a 2-1 lead.
Good things happen when you funnel to the net. That's exactly what Galchenyuk does. Disrupts the play a little bit. And for Pacioretty, he's throwing this into the mix, trying to look for a redirection, and he gets one. Might have been off Klefbom here. The defender trying to take Galchenyuk going to the net. Gets in there right off maybe Galchenyuk on the follow-through. Klefbom in there as well, but get a puck to the net, which they've done. And it takes a funny hop, bounces right over the shoulder of Cam Talbot.
It looks like the Canadiens might hang on to win this. Pacioretty again with the empty net. High shot again off the glass. And it comes back near center ice. Byron, he flipped it. Pacioretty third is lucky. Into the middle of the net. And it's a 4-1 Montreal lead. 26 seconds left. 26 seconds left. They wanted goals. They got goals here in the third. Four of them.
I think that's going to seal the deal. When it's meant to be, it's meant to be for Pacioretty. Had two unbelievable chances. He just put over the net. Paul Byron tries for the open net for the hat trick. He's already got two goals right here. And it goes right to Pacioretty for third.
Made it up ahead for Alexander Radulov. Radulov cuts in with it. Dropped it back to No. In his feet to Pacioretty on the backhand. Goal! Max Pacioretty snaps a six-game goalless drought to tie it at one.
The Canadiens just kept coming and coming this period, and what an opportunity earlier from Jeff Petrie, who whistles it wide over the net, and then Deneau drops this puck for Pacioretty, and the backhand by Pacioretty corrals it, throws it at the net, and it squeezes right through Lettinen and trickles into the net.
Jaromir Jagr Played it back up for Keith Yannick. Pass goes off the stick of Huberto. And back the other way. Alexander Radulov with Pacioretty. Feeds it to Pacioretty and scores! That's Pacioretty with his 35th of the year. 4-1 Montreal.
Great patience by Radulov, who realizes he has a two-on-one. As he slows things down, waits for Demers to commit and come over to him, and as soon as he realizes that, watch this beautiful little saucer pass right on the stick of Pacioretty, who threads it through the legs of Reto Berra. That's what goal scorers do. They just know how to release it quickly.